Hello everyone, welcome back to another InDesign CC tutorial. I am your host, Elias Sarantopoulos. In this EPUB tutorial, we are building an interactive quiz with multiple choices and one correct answer with descriptive information. In addition, a choice to start over as well as navigate from page to page. Interactive quizzes can encourage users to engage with your content, test their knowledge, or use it as a great presentation tool. So here's an interactive quiz idea that I put together for you. Inside Adobe InDesign CC, I have already created a quiz with three total questions, a file you will find inside the exercise folder up on the YouTube card or below the video description if you wish to follow along with me. Now, on the left side of the quiz, we have the first question: what does the term gutter mean inside InDesign? A thumbnail image above it representing that answer, the question indicator, and a navigation arrow to go to the next page or the next question. On the right side of the quiz, we have four multiple choices with one correct answer for each question per page. In this case, the quiz consists of three total pages and questions. Now, inside the Layers panel, each of these multiple choices and answers are organized in separate groups containing relevant information which will help us create the multi-state objects. Now, question number two, which is this one, is at the top of the layer stack. Reason for that is since question number two is the correct answer, it also contains the descriptive information box that needs to appear on top of any other box below it and for no other reason. So first we are going to create buttons for each possible answer. So when the user taps or clicks, then each button triggers an action which is to reveal the true or false answer. So let's go ahead and set those up. I'm going to start with question number one here, and I'm going to target the box number one. So you want to click and drag this to the create new layer icon to create a duplicate. Click and drag this inside the question number one, and let's rename this to empty frame. And since it's an empty frame, go ahead and target this. We're not going to have any fill or any color. Okay. So let's target question number two and box number two. Again, duplicate this, click and drag and bring this inside the question two. Rename this to empty frame. Again, target it. No stroke, no fill. Let's go to question number three, target box three, duplicate this, click and drag this and put it inside the question number three. Now, sometimes you might have to do this again, as you can see here in my case, and this has to be inside the question number three. So click and drag again till it goes inside. Rename this to empty frame, target it. No fill, no stroke. And last one is the question number four and box four. Duplicate this, bring it inside. Click to rename this to empty frame. And let's target this one more time. No fill, no stroke. Okay. So we got everything here. Now let's go ahead and create the buttons here. All right, so question number one, empty frame, target this guy here, and we want to convert this selection into a button. So go up to the window menu, interactive, buttons and forms. In this case, I have it right here. So for type, that will be a button, and let's give it a name of trigger BTN, hit enter return. Let's trigger the second empty frame. Let's create a button out of this, trigger BTN, and BTN starts for button. Hit enter return. Let's go to the third empty frame. Convert this to a button. Rename this to trigger BTN. Hit enter, return. And the last one we have is the question number 4. So again, turn this into a button and then rename this to trigger BTN and hit enter, return. Okay, so we got everything we need to go on to the next step and create the object states. So now we are ready to select each of these questions and answers and convert them into multi-state objects. So I'm going to start with the first question. So with the selection tool, I'm going to marquee select this first question and answer. Just make sure you have the layers panel here and you can see what is selected. This is very important. Then go up to the window menu, interactive, and bring up the object states panel. In this case, I have it right here. And then you want to click on this icon here that says convert selection to multi-state object. So you want to click on that. I'm just going to rename this to question 1 MSO. And MSO stands for multi-state object, and hit enter, return. Okay. Now let's go ahead and target the second question. But in this case, I want to make sure that I have toggle on the visibility of all of these question 2, answer 2, and answer info. So hold down the shift key and just target these. Okay. And then again, let's convert this to a multi-state object. In this case, it's going to be the question 2 MSO. Hit enter, return. Select this one, okay, with shift select. Convert this to another multi-state object. That would be the question 3 MSO. Hit enter, return. And lastly, I can just marquee select this and convert this to another MSO, okay, multi-state object. Okay, now there's one more thing we need to do. And this is on question number 2, if you remember, we have an additional descriptive box here. And in this case, well, I need to target this. So click on that, then click on the object states, and then click on the answer to correct. This one has this extra question button, as you can see here, which we need to target, which is this one right here, this info button. It's not a button yet. It will be once we convert it inside the buttons and forms. Again, this is going to be a button. In this case, I'm going to rename this to trigger info BTN, hit enter, return, like so. Let's look at this for a second. Now I am again inside the multi-state object, but just make sure that you have the question 2 selected for the multi-state object. And now we are ready to go on to the next step, which is actually giving proper actions for each of these multi-state objects. So now we are ready to select each of these multi-state objects and their buttons inside and give them appropriate actions so we can create our first EPUB interactivity. Okay, so I'm going to target the question 1 MSO, and I'm going to target the trigger button and go back to the buttons and forms. So here's the trigger button. The event is on release or tap, and the action is go ahead and click on this plus icon here to add a new action for the selected event. In this case, because we only have 2 states on this multi-state object, I'm just going to choose go to next state. The story changes quite a lot on the second MSO here, the question 2 MSO. So first I'm going to target the first state, which has the trigger BTN. So let's give it an action. It will go to a specific state. So you're going to write, you're going to select go to state. In this case, you're going to go to the next state inside that multi-state object. Okay. this is okay, it's correct. We're not done yet on that. Just quickly, let me go ahead and do the other one here. The question two, and let's give it an appropriate action to go to just the next state. And I have one more to go here, which is the fourth question. So target the trigger BTN. Let's also give it an action to just go to next state. Okay, this seems to be working for now, but again, it's not entirely finished. So let's go up to the window menu, interactive. You want to bring up the EPUB interactive, the preview panel here. And at the very bottom here, we're going to target the spread mode and not the document mode. Okay, just gonna test that for now. So click to play. Let's test that. This works. This works. This works. This works as well, but this one here doesn't work yet. So we need to set this up as well. So in this case, let's go ahead and target the question two MSO. Click on the MSO here, the object state, and then target the second state. This state has this icon here. So inside the layers panel, open that up. Here's the trigger info BTN. Let's target this. Let's give it an action that will go to a specific state. And this state will be to go to this one that has the descriptive information box. Okay. So let's go ahead and test that. So click to play the preview again. That works very well. What doesn't work is, well, we have no action here. Okay, so we need to set that up. So back on the multi-state object, just make sure that you're on this one here, on the second one. Target the third state inside the question two MSO. And inside the layers panel, we're going to target the close button. Well, it's not a button yet. We're going to convert this to a button. So click on that. Back on the buttons and forms, convert this to a button. Actually, I'm going to rename this to close BTN. Hit enter return. And then for an action, go to a specific state. Which state? Well, it's going to go back to, let's say, this state, the second one. Okay, so let's go ahead and test that inside the EPUB interactive preview here. Click to play. This works. We close it. It goes back to the state, which is exactly that's what we want. So we can read this over and over again. So that is correct as well. Okay, there we go. Now, we also need to let users restart the quiz at any time and get the right answers. So this time around, we will target the start over button, but it's not a button yet. So let's go ahead and create one. All we have here inside the start over is the start over text and a rectangle. So I'm going to use the rectangular frame tool. I'm going to click and drag to create one empty frame like so. And then I'm going to click and drag this and bring it inside the group, the start over group. Click on the buttons and forms, convert this to a button. Let's give it another name, start over BTN, hit enter return. And now we're just going to give several actions. The first action is to go to a state. The first state will be to target the first MSO, the question one MSO, and then it will target the first state inside that MSO. Click the plus icon here to create another action that will go to the second question MSO, and that will target the first state inside that multi-state object. Let's create another action that will go to a state. We will target the third question, and inside that MSO, we will target the first state. And lastly, we're going to add another action to go to state. And this time around, we're going to target the last question multi-state object, and we're going to target the first state. Okay, so let's go ahead and test this. So I'm just going to click on this one, let's say, and we can start all over, or this one, doesn't really matter. everything works at this point. There is one more interactivity that we need to work on, which is start the quiz and then navigate from page to page. The rest is exactly the same as we already covered by creating buttons, multi-state objects, and appropriate actions. Okay, so for that, I'm going to jump on the first page here, and I have this take the test, and all you see inside the group is just the text and the rectangle. Again, we're going to create a clear frame, an empty frame here, which we're going to click and drag this inside the group. And let's convert this to a button. And that would be, let's say, start BTN, hit enter return. And this actually is going to go to page. Well, we're on page one, as you can see here as well. So we're going to go to page two, hit enter return, and that should work. Let's go to the second page. We're going to target, let's look inside the layers here, the next arrow, which is this one right here. Okay, same story. We have an empty frame here and an arrow. So for this empty frame, I'm going to convert this into a button. I'm going to call this next BTN, and that will go to page. Well, we are on the second page, so we need to go to the third page, hit enter return. There we go. Let's go ahead and go to the third page here. Now we have two buttons, the previous and the next. So inside the preview arrow here, we have an empty frame. Convert this to a button. I'm going to rename this to previews BTN. So it's going to go to the page. Well, we are on the third now. We need to go to the second. So this is going to go to the second. Hit enter return. And then let's work on this next. Again, we're going to convert this into button. That will be next BTN. Hit enter return. It's going to go to the last page, which is the fourth page. Enter return. And lastly, we have the last page, which you only have one previous arrow here. So I'm going to target the empty frame. I'm going to convert this into a button. And that will be previous BTN. And it's going to go to page. It's going to go to the third page. Hit enter return. And let's test the whole thing. In this case, I'm not going to click on the set preview spread mode rather than the set preview document mode, because we're going to start from the very beginning. Let's go ahead and take the quiz. Next. Previous page. Next question. Next. That works as well. This works. Just double checking my work. There we go. And then we can start all over again. And pretty much the quiz is completed. All you have to do is continue, as I mentioned before, the process, and everything should work perfectly fine. Again, you can create your own quizzes with your own questions, and it's quite an effective way to add interactivity inside your EPUB. Thank you everyone for spending time with me. Let me know if you have any questions or suggestions. And don't forget to subscribe and share the knowledge.